Jay Shrek.
I'm James.
Now, hell are we at today, James?
We're on our way to the Wave Cave and the Superstitions.
You know, how in the hell have we never been here? We've hiked all over Arizona, and we've never been to a place that's like in our backyard, right?
Yeah, we were just joking about the fact that somehow this is the first time we're on this trail.
Now, it's Wednesday, right?
It is a Wednesday.
And there's a full parking lot. I'm not used to hiking anywhere. There's a full parking lot, right?
Yeah, this summer we got spoiled.
Now, I didn't know when you came off the Kings Highway that there were all these cool houses up here. God, if I could afford it, I think I'd kind of like to live up here, James.
Yeah, I had no idea how big Gold Canyon was, man.
Well, there's supposed to be petroglyphs, and there's some history of this trail also, but we're going to go take a, you know, we're not going to be alone today, that's for sure. We're definitely going to have a lot of company.
So, as is custom, we'll check out our little trailhead. This tells us where to go and what to do. Hieroglyphic Trail. This is in proximity to Peralta. So what do you think?
I think we should just get on the road to ruin.
Let's start hiking. It's kind of like Disneyland. There might be a line. Off we go.
You know, James, this is a beautiful trail. You know, it's kind of weird when you look down here, though, and you go, well, I'm not in the middle of nowhere. I'm South Mountain, right?
Definitely in the neighborhood.
But, boy, if you look up in here.
Yeah, man.
This is gorgeous. Beautiful. Beautiful cactus through here. And, you know, well-traveled road. You know, you're not going to get stressed as a hiker going to this.
Yeah, a little super highway.
You know, James, I don't know how to act today. It's not 100 million degrees. I'm actually chilly. And then when you start sweating. So one of the things to remember when it starts to cool down is make sure that you have appropriate clothes, because all of a sudden I'm in shorts and short sleeves and I start sweating, and then you sit down and guess what? Gets cold, and then hypothermia. Because this time of the year, what happens a lot of times here, especially on South Mountain, is people get hypothermia because they're not prepared that it's going to get cold as soon as they stop hiking. So make sure that you're prepared when you come out here. And even though you may not want to drink water like you did in the summer, you sure in the hell need to.
Another tip, wear synthetic clothes. Moisture wicking is really important because it'll dry out a lot faster than a cotton shirt and stuff like that.
Well, and you look cooler.
And you look way.
Because you're like, oh, look at him. He's got wiki.
But this is a nice hike, man. We're like at a halfway point, I'm going to guess. We've never done this, so we're just kind of feeling our way through.
But definitely a nice family, dog friendly.
Yeah, you could definitely enjoy this with kids and dogs, and no one's gonna die on you.
I seem to think that the quality of the adventure is the difficulty on getting there, right?
Yeah, we tend to fall in that boat, so yeah,
you know,
exactly.
But there's nothing wrong with, you know, you're on a Saturday, your day off, and you can still do a quick morning hike and then still do the stuff that you need to get done. You know, I'm that guy, James. If I don't have to crawl through hell and drive 15 miles off road, then I don't see the value in the hike or the adventure. And you know, that's where I've got to change as well, is I've got to figure out that.
That's why we've lived here most of our lives and yet to do this trail.
And I've hiked every trail in Arizona, but the easy one near the house. Why is that? Tell you what, James, this is really, you know, if you're thinking about coming here and hiking, and you're from Kansas, for example, this would be a good trail to break yourself in versus Siphon Draw.
Agreed.
You know, it's got a nice slope. You know, you're inclining, but it's not like deadly. And man, it's really got a beautiful, beautiful trail side.
Nice.
Look at it through here. It's just very picturesque. I'm gonna rate this trail pretty high, James.
To the spot with the glyphs. This is really awesome drainage we're kind of cruising around in. What do you think?
You know, look at the slides up there too, where it's washed down. And then look at how rugged this is. You know, I don't know, up here I'm not sure if this was transient, you know. But we know Geronimo was up here. We know the Apaches were up here. So, you know, these, the mountains of superstition never disappoint. And I'll tell you what, there is a good, if we sit here and shoot a lap, look how fast they're moving regular. These guys right here.
Little sperm dude.
Yeah, I saw him, but look at these square-headed guys.
Yeah, square heads?
Yeah, look at them.
Oh, nice. Oh, those are different.
You know, what we found here is a couple square-headed guys that are really intriguing. They're off the back wall. So, I'm trying to see if maybe somebody'd actually, you know, if they're more modern, but I don't believe so. Look at that right there. That's pretty incredible.
Coyote. That's older too. Even with the water damage, it's older stuff. Little coyote. Square heads are hard to get a good angle on.
Those are some of the best ones I've seen up here so far. You know, look at this cave. You know, do you know that ancients were in it because they were along these walls right here? And if you come in here, I'll tell you what, it's pretty cool. It's not big, but you can get out of the weather, definitely. And somebody's had a fire in here. I can't tell you who, but could have been. But I'll tell you what, this is absolutely beautiful.
True.
This is badass, though. This is cool.
This is a nice little cave. There's a nice little view out of this cave.
That is cool.
That's nice. I like that. Good deal.
Man, this is awesome. This
well, is... we'll figure it out here.
Well, you know what? We're on the journey to find Wave Cave. And, you know, we've seen a lot of pictures of yoga pants hikers. And, you know, I don't have a problem with that.
Nothing wrong with that.
Except I don't have any yoga pants, and I haven't been to hot yoga.
And he told me I'm not allowed to wear my yoga pants anymore.
Almost a week. And so now it's a matter of... trying to figure out where the hell we're gonna go.
So we did find out we want to head to Kearney Springs Trailhead.
Well, James, I wouldn't say we're in BFE today, would you?
Definitely not BFE.
But you know, if you look on this sign right here at the Lost Gold Mine Trail, one thing is that this was a great hike, really a good hike. I would list it about a 2 out of 5 as far as difficulty. Nice, easy family hike, really cool when you get up the Petroglyphs up there on top. And you know, you're definitely not in the middle of nowhere or out in it, but it's still a great place, a great sign. And now we're gonna go from this trail to try to find the Wave Trail, which is 3 miles that would be east of us roughly, and see if we can't find that one. And see if we can't really blow my leg completely out today.
Yeah, that's what we're going for.
We were going to go to Haunted Canyon, but it was like, man, I didn't feel like 10 miles today, and probably today we'll end up doing 12. So
yeah.
Somehow that always works like that, right?
Why not, right? Well, you can do some good hiking even when you're not in BFE. I'm going to take a picture of me up at the Wave Cave. There it is.
This is it right here.
So this must be it. Google Siri just told me.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Look at this.
Oh, man. See, this is where we're kind of jerks.
No parking on road, overload parking at Lost Gold Mine Trail, man. These gals are leaving. So we gotta get
So it's
a
just
spot.
Like the grocery store.
Look at this, yoga women, yoga pants.
I told you, man.
See? Jay Shrek!
James.
You know we're on part 2, aren't we, James?
We are on part 2.
So take a ride up to the the Wave Cave. We've already seen that the whole parking lot is completely full.
Yeah, it's and, a very popular site.
Now, I love Peralta Trail, though. Peralta Trail is one of my favorite trails.
Absolutely.
So,
we've done extensive stuff out there.
Now, on all trails, somebody said there was bushwhacking, and I'm looking at a Jeep trail that we're hiking on right now.
It's as though that is not going to be the case today.
So, at one time, there might have been that, though, right?
Yeah, well, that was a Hike AZ, which, you know, has been around for a while. Yeah, so who knows, man? The trail. Marked so insanely clear.
Wave Cave Trail.
Brand new, it looks like.
Well, it's almost like we took a Jeep trail up here, right?
Yeah, that's a super highway. I don't know if you can see that enough.
Gosh, it's just so funny to think that this would have been cool when you had to bushwhack it, though.
Absolutely.
This would have been cool.
Cool terrain. Everything out here, everywhere you go, it's like something a little different, I notice, when we come up into the soups. Look at that view.
Oh, it's really spectacular up here.
It's gorgeous.
You know, even on the other side was nice.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, James just shot those two saguaros
way up there.
You know, the one side of me is like, I'm happy for the trail markers. The other side is, come on.
It's excessive.
But it does.
You really have to earn this.
See, those guys are behind us. We got to get a lot of B-roll.
Yeah.
Because this is beautiful.
Yeah, this is an awesome spot, man.
I mean, for whatever it lacks, for whatever, it's...
Oh, yeah.
It's really pretty cool.
Nice.
Yeah, it didn't look like anybody's been in it. But it's kind of funny. It seems like it'd be a perfect area for somebody to get up in.
You know,
it's a weird knock on the. Okay. We're in the wave cave, bro. I'll tell you what, this is cool. You know, you never know what you're gonna get into on any of these adventures. But I tell you what, I'm sure in the hell glad I came here. Now, that looks like fire. So, here, all the way across, it could be algae. Never even looked at it. So this was a cool place, cool hike. Huge, I wouldn't expect it to be this big. I thought it'd be, you know, just a little crappie.
You guys are in the wind cave. That's way small.
So James, what do you think?
Oh, this is cool. I can see why people hike up here.
You know, for it being overdone and overmarked and over everything, it's still well worth the hike, though.
It's a rad hike.
It really is cool. This is a pretty unique place. I imagine the guy that bushwhacked this the first time. Now, the funny thing was, this trail really didn't exist till 2002, from what I understand, right?
That's when the dude, like, named the cave we read, but...
And all of a sudden, because it's called the Wave Cave, which makes perfect sense, that's an awesome picture right there. So this is the adventure we called the Wave Cave. What do you think, James?
I like the Wave Cave, man. It was a cool trail.
You know, it was kind of weird because it was kind of like mall hiking.
Yes.
But it was spectacular when you got up there, man. It was beautiful. You got to do it. But you know, the first quarter of it is like walking through the mall parking lot. Well, how beautiful is this? I mean, this is, you know, and the only part that, you know, the upper section, you know, we're going to rank this 3-2, 3-3, only because that last section was pretty steep, and a lot of people wouldn't want to go, you know, and I'm not saying, you know, most people would be able to make it. Pretty slippery on the top up there.
Grandma.
Yeah.
But I'm going to see a picture of Grandma up here tomorrow, so.
Grandma's going to be pissed at you. It wasn't me who said that. That was James, okay?
James. So. Scorpion's a dick.
Because, you know, somebody's grandma could be an ass-kicking hiker. But I tell you what, I would do it. I would definitely do it. So we're going to get down in about 45 minutes. That's about right. I probably slowed us down about 30 up that hill. You know, I don't want to call it a mall hike, but...
But it's a mall hike.
But it was cool. I mean, I really enjoyed it.
I'm glad we did this today.
I mean, we did two great hikes today. That was awesome. I mean, it finished a good day up. And we're in golden hour, which should be shooting well. So, you know.
It sure is nice just to, like, stop every once in a while and look around. I mean, this is just beautiful out here.